is Penny, and these are the KidVision Kids, and we're here today at the Museum of Discovery and Science in Fort Lauderdale to find out about simple machines.
Well, my name is Leah. I'm one of the educators here at the museum, and you guys are in the right place because we have our new science park, which has lots of different simple machines for you guys to learn about.
Woohoo! Are you ready to find out about simple machines?
Yay!
All right, let's hit it.
All right. So simple machines are a way to make work easier.
Great. What simple machine are we at right now?
Right now we're going to learn about pulleys. So pulleys can make work easier because we can lift heavy things, like construction cranes can lift big blocks up to build buildings. So there's usually wheels involved, and with our pulley systems, the more pulleys that you have, the easier the work. So Miss Penny's going to show you guys how you're going to pull up. So with this is our pulley. Here you guys can see there's a two. So there's actually two wheels here that have the rope, okay? And then up top, there are two more. So with this pulley that she's on, there's actually four pulleys that she's going to be pulling on. Let's see how she pulls herself.
Yeah. Are you ready?
Yes.
Set, go. I'm gonna do, oh my goodness.
You guys gotta help her.
This is not as easy as it looks. Wow.
No
way. Oh my goodness.
See, so she's lifting up.
The pulley is helping me lift my body.
All right. So now she's all the way at the top. Now she can let go, and it'll let you down to the bottom slowly.
That was fun and hard. But I can see I can lift myself without the pulley.
Right. So if you had just a regular rope.
If I had to climb the rope, mm-hmm. it would be much harder than using the pulley to help me up the rope.
Yes. My turn.
All right. You guys want to give it a try?
So with the different pulleys we had here, we all felt that with the 1x1 pulley, it only has two pulleys, so we were struggling to pull each other up.
That was the hardest one.
It was the hardest. And then the easiest, Naomi could almost pull herself by herself, was the 2x2. It has four pulleys in it, so it makes work a lot easier. So the more pulleys you have in a system, the easier it is to pull something up.
That's terrific. So we used pulleys. Are you ready to find out about another simple machine?
Yeah!
Awesome!
All right, let's go.
Let's go. And now we're at a different simple machine. Could you please tell us about this simple machine?
All right, so this is our cool fan. It is actually the simple machine of a wheel and an axle. Just like with a doorknob. When you turn the doorknob, right, it releases something to open the door. So as we turn this wheel, it puts energy up the axle and actually spins all of these wheels and transfers the movement down to this fan over here. So if we spin this wheel, we can actually make this fan cool us down. Do you guys want to try it?
Yes.
All right.
Whoa. Here we go.
We are moving the wheel, which is turning the axle, which is making the fan work.
This helps us. If we tried to move the fan all by ourselves, it would be much harder.
Even when we push it just a little bit, right, it turns the fan. We don't even have to use a lot of energy. We can just push it slowly, and the fan starts turning. Let's get in this penny, guys.
There's water. It feels like rain. And now we're at another simple machine. Tell us about this one.
So these are our giant levers. Levers are another simple machine. They have a fulcrum point, which is basically in the center of the lever, and it lets it teeter back and forth.
Okay, so how does the fulcrum work?
So like in a typical seesaw, when we have a fulcrum in the center, right, both sides have an equal effort of work that they have to put in to lift the other side. If the fulcrum moves closer to one side, the person farthest from the fulcrum is going to have an easier time lifting the weight on this side, whereas the person on this side closest to the fulcrum is going to have a really hard time lifting that opposite side. So when you guys tug of war later, whoever has the rope closest to the fulcrum is going to have a really hard time winning against the other side. So with the two levers that we have here, we have ropes at different points, and depending on where the ropes are, it will make the work harder or easier.
That's good information because I'm going to be the winner.
Three, go!
Continuing our lesson on simple machines, now we're going to talk about incline planes, and we're going to build a roller coaster with incline planes.
Yes.
What is an incline plane?
So incline planes are like slides or ramps, right? They help us move something from point A to point B.
Kind of like when you have a delivery truck and he has a ramp so that he can take the furniture down or carry heavy boxes down. He's going down a ramp. That's called an incline plane.
Yes. Or when you guys go down a slide, what's easier, going upstairs or going down a slide?
What's easier, going up the stairs or down the slide?
Down the slide.
Right? It's a lot more work to go upstairs. Can you imagine carrying something very heavy on your back up the stairs?
Yeah.
Or down the stairs, right? So if we put it down a slide or a ramp, it'd make it much easier. So we're going to build some roller coasters, which are like incline planes where we take our ball and move it from one point to another point. Are you guys ready to build some roller coasters?
Yes!
So our first materials are pipes, pipes that will allow the ball to either go through or allow the ball to gain some height. We also have our different attachments like this loop-de-loop. We also have clamps, which will attach to the pipes and allow them to go vertical.
Our roller coasters, they look wonderful. Thanks, Dad, for helping us. It's good to have an engineer who understands that an incline board makes gravity work for us. So we're all going to use our balls and see how our roller coaster rolls. The ball is going to use energy to go down the incline plane using gravity. It has to have just enough energy to make that turn.
Like Miss Penny said, we're using gravity and just enough force and energy to get our ball down the track towards the end.
Thank you, Museum of Discovery and Science, for letting us explore simple machines in your science park. We had a great day.
Bye! Bye.